Hello everyone, and once again welcome to Google Ads course. Myself Umar Taskeer. Guys, in this particular we are going to talk about different bidding strategies in very detail. So in the last video we actually discussed about the two broad categories of bidding strategies. The first one is automated bidding strategy, where we are having different kind of bidding strategies, right? And those kind of bidding strategies are basically driven by Google system. And then we have manual bidding strategy also, that we also called as manual CPC bidding strategy. And in that particular bidding strategy, the advertiser is having most of the control, right? So we have these two bidding strategies at a very broad level. And now in this specific video, we will be discussing more about these kind of bidding strategies, like in very detail with some examples also, that how these bidding strategies actually work, right? So as soon as we come to our campaign settings, and in the bidding section, we are going to see different kind of bidding strategies over here, right? So these are the different bidding strategies. Now I am going to discuss each and every bidding strategy in very detail. So when I say target CPA, so let me write this thing over here so that I can explain you in much detail. Whenever we say target CPA, right, it's target CPA, which means that target cost per action, right? Target cost per action. Action can be anything, like it can be a conversion for you, right? Action can be a conversion for you. Action can also be like a form fill, right? Action can also be a form fill. So these different things can be the action, right? So now you are telling that Google basically that, okay, I wanted to go with target CPA. So I want to achieve a conversion, or we can say that I want to achieve an action, but I do not want to pay more than a certain amount, right? So you are basically telling Google that, okay, target this much cost per action, right? For example, let's take an example. So suppose if you are selecting target CPA, right, target CPA, what will happen is, now you will be telling Google that, okay, I wanted to put target CPA somewhere around rupees 100, which means that I am willing to pay, maximum I am willing to pay rupees 100 per action, right? So this is what you should optimize our campaigns for. This is what you should consider while showing my impressions to different audiences, right? So this is basically the target CPA, and it is one of the very famous automated bidding strategy, right? So this is it, and let's move to another one, then we'll be discussing something more. The other one is target return on ad spend. When we say target ROS, which means that target return on ad spend. So let me make another chart over here and bidding strategies or automated bidding strategies, and I'll be writing target ROS over here. So it is target ROS, which means target return on ad spend. Okay, this is target return on ad spend. So now you are telling Google basically that, okay, I will be putting my budget to be somewhere around rupees 1000, right? And my return on ad spend, I want my return on ad spend to be like 200% or 100%. I want my return on ad spend to be 100%, which means that now you are telling Google that I want conversions worth rupees 2000, right? I want conversions worth rupees 2000. Then only it will be somewhere around 100% return, right? Or it will be basically exact 100% return. So now you have this option where target ROS you can select, and which means that target return on ad spend. So whatever ad spend will be there, whatever your budget is there, now you are telling Google that I want 2x of this as return, or I want 3x of this as return. Now what are the limitations with these two bidding strategies? When we talk about the CPA, which is called cost per action, right, or the cost per goal, and the second one is target ROS, target return on ad spend. Now these two bidding strategies basically work well when you have some past data, right? So when you have some past data, and when you have enough past data. See, if you do not have data, they cannot optimize your campaigns. Google will not be able to basically optimize your campaign. So all the automated bidding strategies works on the foundation that you have enough data. If you do not have enough data, they will not be able to optimize your campaigns automatically. So bidding strategies are best suited when you have some data, or when you have already have account which is basically an established one. You have already run some campaigns over there. You have some art groups over there, you have some data, you have some, I mean, you have things over there so that Google can use that data to optimize your campaign, right? So these bidding strategies, these all bidding strategies, which are basically into these automated bidding strategies, are related or directly related with the information. So it is kind of a proportional relation between how old is your ad account and how successful your this bidding strategy will be, right? So as old your ad account is, there are high chances that your bidding strategy, automated bidding strategy, will work well, right? Then we have maximize clicks. So we are now telling Google that, okay, I want to have maximum clicks, no matter how much I am about to pay, right, for a single click, but try to show our ads to the people who are most likely to click on our ad. So this is basically maximize clicks strategy. And then there is maximize conversion. So now maximize conversion is like, now you are telling Google, fine, you are telling Google that, okay, this one is conversion for us. You have to define the conversion first, right? So once you have created your Google ad account and now you are ready with your landing page, now next thing which you have to do is basically you have to define the conversions. Whatever the conversions are there on your landing page, you have to define those conversions. So this is again a very important thing that you have to do, right? You have to define the conversions. If you are not going to define the conversions, Google will not be able to understand that what are conversions for us. So you have to define basically, right? So conversion can be anything. Let's suppose if you are having a conversion as lead. Now lead is captured or lead is marked or lead is submitted as soon as someone comes to your website, fills a form, and then they are redirected to some thank you page over there, right? So as soon as the thank you page loads, which means that a lead is captured. So now you have to tell this thing to Google that, okay, I'm creating a conversion and this conversion will be counted only when this thank you page triggers or when this thank you page loads, right? So you can create these conversions, right? You just have to go to this tools and settings and then there is conversion option. So you have to create this conversion. And once you have created your conversion and you started running your campaigns, right? You started your running your campaigns on manual CPC. Suppose you started running your campaigns on manual CPC and you got like 30 conversions or 40 conversions, right? Now, if you are moving to this maximize conversion bidding strategy, it will be more effective for you. Why? Because you already have some conversions. When you already have some conversions, Google knows that, okay, these were the people who actually converted. This was the keyword which actually triggered the ad. And after clicking on that ad, this guy converted. This guy belongs from Delhi. This guy's demographics are recorded into Google Ads, right? So all the information about the conversion and the person who actually converted or the lead is there with Google Ads. So now Google Ads is having some information like who converted and from where they converted. So these kind of informations are there with Google Ads. Now if there are like 30 conversions, then all the information is there with Google Ads for all those 30 conversions. So that is a quite good information that Google Ad is having right now. Now, if you are going to Google and saying that, okay, now you have the information regarding our conversions, you know what kind of people are converting on our website or what conversions are actually for us, right? What kind of people are making the conversions? Now, I am giving control to Google. Earlier, the control was with us when we were bidding on manual CPC, or we can say that manual cost per click. We were bidding on manual cost per click. There, the control was in our hand. We have to decide about the biddings. We have to put the biddings over there. But now we are not having the bidding control. We are giving bidding control to Google that, okay, now I am giving you some data also. We know that these are the conversions. You also know that. The Google system also knows that. Now these are the conversions. Now I am giving you the control that, okay, maximize our conversions. No matter how much cost we are about to pay for a single click. But yes, maximize the conversion. So when there is some data, it becomes easy for Google to understand what kind of people are actually converting. So now Google will be showing your ad to those kind of people only. So there will be higher chances of getting conversion. So now this is how we should utilize or we should use the automated bidding strategy. So first of all, we should stick ourselves to manual bidding strategies only, right? Let some data come, right? Let some data come and make sure that data is perfect. If you are not satisfied with your conversions, if the conversions quality is not good and you are moving to automated bidding strategies, And Google Ads system will be using the data from that low quality conversion itself, right? In that case, what will happen? In that case, if the source data is not good, if the quality of source data is not good, your result will also not be good, right? So this is one thing that you have to keep in your mind, that once you are satisfied that, okay, these were the conversions that we were looking for. Now, these are good conversions. These people actually converted. These are good conversions. Now, we wanted to use these conversions as our base, and we wanted to have same kind of people for more conversions. Now, if this is what you think and this is what actually happened, then only you can go to, or then only you should go to this automated bidding strategy, right? So this is the basic difference between manual bidding strategy, that is manual CPC, and automated bidding strategy, that is automated bidding strategy. You have so many options out there, right? So I believe this thing is now clear, that in this automated bidding strategies, everything is data. So if your account is old and you are having enough data, in most of the cases, your bidding strategy will work, right? Then we have maximized conversion value. Now, how this actually works, whenever you define your conversion, right? Whenever you define your conversion, you also associate a value, a monetary value to that conversion, right? So suppose let's take another cool example over here. So if we open another thing over here, and let's say we are having different conversions, right? We can define multiple conversions on our website. So if there is one conversion, right, this is conversion one, and its monetary value is rupees 100. So if this conversion is happening, what I am getting in return is like 100 rupees, right? So let's put another conversion value over here. And then there is conversion number 2, and we have conversion value for this conversion is like 200 rupees. And then we have conversion 3, conversion name 3, and we have the conversion value for this specific conversion as rupees 150. So let's put rupees over here, let's put rupees over here, let's put rupees over here. So we have now 3 conversions, right? So when we are bidding on maximize conversion, what happens is, let me tell you about maximize conversions. What happens is, Google will try to show your ad to the people who are most likely to convert, no matter what conversions they are making. Maybe this can be like a phone call. This conversion is basically a phone call for you. This conversion can be something like a lead submission. This can be something like a PDF download on your website. PDF download on your website. So these are the 3 different conversions, right, that you have actually defined. And now you're going to Google that, okay, maximize conversion. Now you have set this bidding strategy where you have capped this maximize conversion. Now what Google will do? Google will try to maximize your conversions. Means that Google will try to give you maximum conversions, no matter that conversion is conversion number 1, 2 or 3. Because this time, the main focus of Google is to increase the numbers of your conversions, right? To give you maximum conversions. There's nothing about the monetary value of conversion. But when you go to Google and say maximize conversion value, so first of all, what Google will do is, Google will try to give you conversions of higher values first. Google will try to give you conversion number 2, right? First of all, Google will try to give you conversion number 2. And if somehow Google is not able to bring conversion number 2 for you, so next Google will try to give you conversions of conversion number 3, right? So this is how it actually works when you are putting this maximized conversion value, where Google is basically focusing on the value. It is focusing on providing you the maximum value, right? Earlier, when it was maximized conversion, Google was only focusing on increasing the number of the conversions, right? Increasing the number of conversions. But this time, Google is focusing on increasing the conversion value, right? So this is the difference between maximize conversion and maximize conversion value. And then there is another very interesting type of automated bidding strategy, which is target impression share. So if you wanted to show your ad anywhere, like anywhere, so it's showing anywhere on the result page, and if you wanted to have the 50% of the impressions, which means that if you hover on this small I button, it says that is how often you want to ads to appear in the search page when other people search for your keywords. So anyone searching for your keywords like 100 of times, and you want 50% of the times, 50% of the times your ad should appear. So in this case, Google will try to bid higher when you are saying that, okay, I want to show my ad no matter where it is showing on the first page, but it should be there on the results page, anywhere on the results page, no matter if it is there in topmost positions or the bottom position, no matter, it actually does not matter. We want our ad to be shown on result pages, and 50% of the times we want impression. Then we have other option also, top of the result page. Now this time we are very much specific that we want to show our ad at the top of the page, and we want to show our ad for the 50%, right? Then we have this absolute top of the result page, which is basically the position number one. So this time we are very much again specific that, okay, we want to show our ad at position number one, or if there are like 10 searches, if there are like 10 searches of our keywords, this time we want 5 times our ads to appear on the top, absolute top of the result page, no matter how much amount they charge, Google charges for getting a click, right? So amount is not a constraint here in this specific case when we are doing impressions here, but still they are providing us the control of this maximum CPC bid limit, that so that you can actually control, okay, fine, I will not pay more than rupees 200, and I also want this thing, right? So if there are cases which matches both the conditions, like you are getting results at the absolute top of your result page, or your ad is showing at the absolute top of the result page and it is showing at the 50% times, and also if the maximum CPC is not going to be somewhere more than 200 rupees, if all the conditions are meeting, your ad will trigger, right? So this is how it actually works. And first of all, my recommendation is start with manual bidding, learn that how actually keywords perform and how can you basically play with the bids and keywords. So you have to understand that thing. Once the data is there in your Google Ads account, and you are done with some of your campaigns, you can definitely switch to automated bidding strategy. The only automated bidding strategy that I will recommend you to start with, if you are new and you wanted to go with bidding strategy, automated bidding strategy only. So the only automated bidding strategy that I will recommend is maximize clicks. You can go with maximize clicks, but do not go with maximize conversions until unless you are not having good conversions. Do not go with return on ad spend until unless your ad account is not having a very good data. So keep these things in mind and start running your campaigns. So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.